March 23rd, 2017. It's a Thursday, but the movie is premiering tonight early because they can't really do midnight premieres or whatever. But I'm here with my girlfriend and her mom, and we're about to go buy the tickets. She's looking at me. But yeah, guys, we're going to hang around for a bit because the movie didn't start in like an hour. So we're going to buy tickets in 30 minutes, and then we're going to go in and see it. So yeah. Showing the first looks and shit. No movie yet, we're just waiting and stuff, and there's a lot of people, so there's a lot of people. There's a few people. There's some little kids, and I was kind of worried because I don't want little kids like crying and stuff while the movie's on. But you know, everybody's really just hyped and stuff, and yeah. And I saw a guy with a Red Ranger shirt. Alicia, come on. We out here waiting for this movie. I just realized the best way to not have people sit next to you, because I don't want anybody to sit next to me. I want to enjoy this movie in peace, is to film yourself in the movie theater. That's what I'm doing right now. I'm breaking the rules. I'm going to film the entire movie, Lionsgate. Get ready. It hasn't started yet, but it's going to start soon. Don't worry, guys. Hey guys, it is 11:40 p.m. and I'm back from the movie theater, and Power Rangers was amazing, but I'm very tired, so I'll see you guys tomorrow on the 24th, and I'll tell you guys about the movie then, and I'm gonna go to sleep because I'm super tired. So, bye. Power Rangers is neither the campy fun of its TV predecessor nor the blockbuster action of its cinematic superhero competitors, and sadly never quite manages to shift into turbo for some good old-fashioned morphing time. Hey guys, Roberto here, and today is March 24th, 2017, and today the Power Rangers movie is out in theaters. You guys can go see it right now. You know, it's lit, guys, it's lit. And yesterday I went to see the movie. I went to see the premiere night or whatever. It came out, it was at 7 p.m. It was out at 7 p.m, so that's kind of weird. I'm confused as to how they say the movie comes out on the next day, but they're showing it like the day before, like at 7 p.m. But I got to see it, and it was amazing. And I'm on Twitter today, and I'm checking Twitter and stuff, and I see that there's a link to the Rotten Tomatoes website, and there's a section for the Power Rangers movie, and there's a rating for the movie, and the movie is currently rotten. That's what it's considered in Rotten Tomatoes. If it's rotten, it's bad, and it's 43%. And this is the review. What I just read is the review of, I guess that's the critic consensus or whatever you want to say. What the hell is consensus, bro? I've never heard that word before. And I posted a picture about it on Instagram, on Ranger Mania's official Instagram, and I put Rotten Tomatoes, be quiet, like, you guys go watch the movie with an open mind, because Rotten Tomatoes is wrong. This movie was amazing. I went to see it last time with my girlfriend, and I had so much fun watching that movie, and it felt so surreal that I was watching a Power Rangers movie in theaters. And just to see some random website, say that the movie's bad and you shouldn't go see it and it's rotten. It's a stupid thing to do. Honestly, at the end of the day, I think that at this point, I'd rather just if you're, I'm the type of person that I'm a dick writer when it comes to stuff like this, because when I see that people say, oh, it's a bad movie, don't go watch it, I don't go watch it. I've done this before where I've gone to like the theater and I said, oh, like what movie are you gonna watch? And if I see the movies like rotten, I'm just like, nah, I'm not watching that. So yeah, but I finally realized that it's better to just have an open mind and go watch the movie and think about it for yourself. Because this movie was amazing, and the fact that Rotten Tomatoes is giving them a bad review, it's crazy, man. All right, guys, so when I got to the movie theater, me and my girlfriend, we paid for our tickets. They gave us these little poster cards, and it was like the team, the Power Rangers from this new movie, and they were all posing, and it was a really cool thing. I didn't really expect that. I didn't expect them to give that thing out. I thought that was just like a thing because I did see some of the Power Force members actually got invited to see the movie in Los Angeles, like premiere night or whatever. And actually had those two. They had like an like I think it was the same thing, or like it was like a different picture or whatever. It was the same poster card that had the team, and the lady at the counter said that it was apparently it's like a special poster they're giving out for the ticket. So maybe they I think they're doing that for like everybody that goes to see the movie and buys tickets and stuff. And yeah, when I got inside the movie theater, I was kind of freaked out because I was expecting like little kids to be around. And you guys know, like, little kids, let's be truthful, they can get a little bit annoying because, you know, they're little kids. And the movie is PG-13, but it's Power Rangers, so little kids are gonna go see it. But I expect the little kids to be running around and crying and screaming and this and that. But it turns out there was, like, two kids and, like, everybody else was just, like, adults. I saw a bunch of fans with Power Rangers shirts. I saw one guy with MMPR red shirt. I saw another guy with, like, the entire, like, he had, like, a shirt that was black and he had the entire team. And I felt kind of bad because I just went there with like this pink sweater. Like, I didn't really like get dressed the right way. I was actually planning on bringing the Morpher, but I had my camera, I had my phone on me, I had my wallet on me, and it was a lot of stuff to carry, and I didn't really want to bring a bag because actually, if you bring props or whatever, if you bring a camera to the movie theater, they're gonna think you're trying to copy, film the movie, and bootleg it or whatever. So I decided to just not bring too much stuff, and yeah, so I just hit the camera. I literally just filmed the intro, and then I didn't even film the logo of the movie. The logo of the movie actually appears at the very bottom. It doesn't appear like this big Power Rangers thing, which is very, very different, but it's fun. It's fun to see that they changed it up a little bit. I expected it to be like Power Rangers, and then like all of a sudden like we cut to a scene where like the team is like doing something, but no, it's just Power Rangers at the bottom. That's it. So that's a little weird, but it's new. It's not something that, you know, I'm gonna bitch about. I'll actually give you guys my thoughts on the pro. I'll give you guys like pros and cons about the movie, but pros are like a big list, and cons is like two things, and that's it. Oh, with the movie, I enjoyed it. I watched it. There was no interruptions. I had a lot of fun. People were saying it's Morphin time before the movie started. People clapped when the Rangers like they got on their Zords and they started their Zords started moving, and the thing was going go go Power Rangers. Like, and I loved every second of it. I liked the fact that one of the main plots of the movie was the Rangers. For them to morph, they actually have to get to know each other and have to get along. It has to be like a teamwork type of thing. Because in the beginning of the movie, none of the Rangers really knew each other. They didn't really get along. And Zordon told them like, oh, like you guys just have to keep training. You guys have to keep training. He kept sending them back to train because the Rangers, they'd be like, all right, we're ready to morph, and they wouldn't morph. And the thing for this movie to morph, you literally have to be like, you have to get along with your entire team to be able to morph. And that's what I really liked about it, that it was the basis of Power Rangers. Power Rangers is all about teamwork. Like, it's a group of five that are friends and they get along and this and that. And it was just really cool to see that the Rangers had to get to know each other before they could be superheroes that were saving the world. The movie, it's an origin story. It starts off really, really slow. It starts off with the Rangers getting to know each other and each of them having problems in life and this and that. And Zordon's history with Rita and why Rita is there and how she woke up and this and that and how the power coins are discovered. You guys have to see the movie for yourself. I'm not going to tell you guys like the entire movie, word by word, but the movie was an origin story, and that's what you can expect. Don't expect the Rangers to pop up out of nowhere in the first 2 seconds when they're fighting. I mean, that's actually what happens. The Rangers are fighting, but it's like 2 seconds, and then after that, we just cut to the teens just hanging out. And yeah, guys, so don't expect a lot of Ranger action. We actually don't get a lot of Ranger action until the very third act. And this is something that kind of bothered me because in the original Mighty Morphin Power Rangers movie, we had Ranger action there. But with Turbo, a Power Rangers movie. I don't know if you guys have seen those movies, but Turbo Power Rangers movie is the worst Power Rangers movie ever. If you guys told me to rate Power Rangers movies from like the top three, I would say this one that I just saw right now. The second one would be Mighty Morphin Power Rangers movie, just for the fact that it's a fun movie. Turbo would be the worst one. It was so boring. I remember having that movie as a kid, and I remember watching it all the time, and I was like, what the hell? Like, I had to wait like 2 hours for the Rangers to actually show up and morph and fight. Like, we got like one, like, we want, like, at one point, Kat transforms into the Zeo Pink Ranger, and then she just, like, goes like 1 second, and then she untransformed because she fell into the water. But yeah, but at the very end is where we get the Turbo Rangers fighting, and I hated that. I hated the fact that it was a Power Ranger movie, but we had, like, Power Rangers at the very end. So this movie, it has a reason for not having that much Ranger action because in the origin story, we're trying to get to know these characters. We don't want you guys to be watching too many Power Rangers fighting, and then we don't even know what the characters are like. We want to see I think that's I want to see more of the Rangers talking and stuff. In the next movie, hopefully they put a lot more Ranger action because it is already established that they're Power Rangers. And yeah, we get some character point like at times, or let's get some characters talking to each other, and let's learn something else about them. But at the same time, let's also, you know. But at the same time, we're gonna get more Ranger action in the next movie. But at the very third act is where they morph, the Zords combine, and everything just happens, and it goes on, and everything's crazy. They fight Rita, and yeah, and some people have said that's a con. They wanted to see more Ranger action, but for me, it was an origin story, so it's fine. Turbo Power Rangers movie didn't have that reason because it was already established that they were Power Rangers. Just give them the Turbo, at least in the original Turbo movie, at least give them the powers at the very first. Like, I know they gave them, like, Larrigo, whatever his name was, he gave the Rangers their powers, like, in the beginning of the movie, or midway, and then they should have morphed, like, at least 3 times in the movie and fought, like, at least a few times. Like, one they win, another one they lose, and in the last third act, they win again, and they're victorious. They should have done that with a Turbo movie, but this movie was more of just, like, training and becoming Rangers and getting to know each other, and we morph. It was basically MMPR Episode 1 if it was a full-length feature movie. They didn't morph until the very end and unlock their Zords and all that. So if you guys ask me what the pros and cons about this movie is, that the pros is that the movie was really, really good at establishing a good story. The characters were amazing. The look of the suits, of the suits. I actually didn't really like the suits before watching the movie. I was like, meh on them. But after seeing that little poster card and seeing the Rangers in action, the suits looked amazing. The storytelling, everything, the music. They used a bunch of pop, hip hop music from Kanye West, Beyonce. There's one scene where Rita's eating a donut in Krispy Kreme, and I'm a Survivor, something like that. I think her song was playing, and it was really, really funny how they used a lot of music that, you know, people listen to today. It wasn't just all like rock music the entire time. It was different genres, and that was really, really cool what they did. Probably the cons is that the only thing con that I have for this movie is that they played the Go-Go Power Rangers theme like for a few seconds, and then after that they stopped. Like, it was just one scene, and that's it. They should have played like the song at least like for most of the time the Rangers were fighting and stuff. They should have done that. That was something that it was like a little nitpick thing. Like, you know, like they just played the theme song for like 2 seconds, and then after that they stopped. But they should have done a lot more. But it was just like one little thing. And yeah, and then like another con I could say was probably they should have made their own version of Mighty Morphin Go Go Power Rangers, not use the original one that was made in the 90s. They should have made at least like a new like a remix. But honestly, like I say that, but then I remember like we've had like 50 remixes of Go Go Power Rangers ever since we started with Samurai. If you guys know that, each new season since 2011, we've been getting the same Go Go Power Rangers theme. So honestly, I'd rather just shut up and not say that. But the only con was probably they didn't play the Go Go Power Rangers theme enough. But yeah, but that was it. All right, guys. So let's look at this Rotten Tomatoes review one more time. I'm gonna analyze it basically. Power Rangers is neither the campy fun. Can't be fun. Are you kidding me? They morphed this. He said it's the Red Ranger said it's morphin' time. They were fighting. The Power Rangers were there. They were actually fighting. Go Go Power Rangers. The theme was playing at least for a few seconds, but we knew it was Power Rangers, so it was okay. They combined the Megazord. The guy said go like a bunch of times. I remember he kept going saying like he said go. And it was a campy fun that we wanted. Rita was such a weird character. She was so cringy at times. And Power Rangers is cringy at the end of the day. You're gonna get campy scenes that are just cheesy, but that's it. That's Power Rangers. The TV predecessor, it's not the same thing. Don't expect the Power Rangers movie to be the same thing as the show. The show is for a younger audience. The movie's more of a, it's you can little kids can still watch it, but it's more of a mature thing. The Rangers do curse at times, but it's not very different. You can say that it's still Power Rangers. That's the cool thing. That's the cool thing about it. Nor the blockbuster action of cinematic superhero. I hate this part. The fact that it says nor the blockbuster action of its cinematic superhero competitors. Don't compare it to Marvel and DC. This isn't Marvel and DC. I hate when they compared it to Marvel and DC. Like, are you kidding me? Like, they have like does everything have to be the same? Does it have to be just like Marvel where oh they crack jokes and they fight? And I like the fact that it's very, very different. It's a little bit. It's like a mix of DC and Marvel, actually. DC is very, very dark. If you guys have seen some of the DC Cinematic Universe movies, like Batman v Superman, you guys have seen that the movies are very, very, really, really dark. And then with Marvel, they're more lighter and they crack jokes and this and that. But imagine both of those combined. That's the Power Rangers movie. It's dark at times, but at the same time, it has its jokes. It's fun. It's a fun movie. And yeah, so that's actually like the cool thing about this movie, and not, oh, like it has to be like the other ones. And sadly, never quite manages to shift into Turbo. Okay, take an L, Rotten Tomatoes, because why would you compare this shit to Turbo, a Power Rangers movie? They literally said shift into Turbo. Like, are you trying to review the Turbo movie or this new movie that came out? For some good old-fashioned Morphin Time, let me just shut up at this point. Like, this is trash reviews. You know, just if this phone wasn't mine, I'd probably chuck it out the window right now with that trash review on there. In the end of the day, guys, just go watch this movie and with an open mind. Just don't look at these reviews. These reviews they don't matter. They're not gonna control your movie-going experience. I didn't let it control my movie-going experience. I saw a few reviews that were saying the movie was gonna suck, and I was worried, and I let the best take on me because I really thought the movie was gonna suck, but I go see this movie and it's amazing. So I'd rather you guys just go see it with an open mind. If you don't like it, then you don't like it, but if you love it, then that's good for you. You love the movie. It's just, it was a good movie. I don't really see a lot of bad things with it. It was times where it was like there was little things here and there that bothered me, but it wasn't such a horrible movie like they're making it out to look. Like, this is Power Rangers at its core. It was Power Rangers. It's what you expect from a Power Ranger movie in this day and age. Hey guys, so those are my thoughts on the movie. And wait, there's one more thing to mention. I don't know if this is a pro or a con, but Saban, that product placement with Krispy Kreme, it was like 50 times, like every single moment of the movie, like Krispy Kreme was mentioned. I don't know if this is a pro or con to you guys, I don't really care. It was funny that I kept seeing, like, they kept mentioning Krispy Kreme, and there were scenes of the Krispy Kreme shop and the donuts and all that stuff, because, you know, you guys know that Power Rangers has, like, the movie has, like a tie-in with Krispy Kreme or whatever, and, you know, they're making Power Rangers donuts. I made a video on that. It was uploaded on a Friday. Yeah, but there was a lot of product placement when it came to Krispy Kreme, but yeah, but still, the movie was good. You know, Krispy Kreme was just like a side thing. Like, it was really cool that they kept mentioning it. It was like Ernie's, it was like the modern day Ernie's juice bar or whatever. But yeah, guys, but in the end of the day, fuck you, Rotten Tomatoes. Power Rangers was good, and it's Morphin Time.